Bomarito Automotive Group.
Hi, everybody, and welcome in to the show after the show on this rainy Thursday morning. I'm Randy Naughton, and for those of you who live, work, or go to play in the Metro East, we have some breaking news for you. We are just finding out right now into our newsroom, in fact, moments ago from the Illinois government, Illinois Department of Public Health, today announced moments ago, Region 4, which includes Bond County, Clinton, Madison, Monroe, Randolph, St. Clair, Washington, they are moving to phase 4 of the Restore Illinois plan, and it's effective today. Now, what does that mean? For phase 4 guidelines, it means restaurants and bars, indoor dining and drinking will now be permitted for parties up to 10 people. Seated areas should be arranged that tables allow for 6 feet between parties. Then there should be barriers. For retail, continue capacity at no more than 50%. Personal care, hairdressers, things like that, no more than 50% occupancy. Indoor and outdoor recreation. Indoor recreation will operate at less of 50 customers or 50% of capacity, like playgrounds and trampoline parks are going to remain closed. Museums, no more than 25% occupancy. Guided tours, limited to 50 or fewer people. 50 people or 50% for meetings and social. So there you go. Moving forward in Illinois, reopening, as we mentioned, restaurants and bars. This coming from the Illinois Department of Public Health moments ago. It literally just came into our newsroom at 9:02. And now that happens ahead of a decision which is coming tonight for the Illinois High School Association. Will they be allowing high school sports? Now, they are proposing that high school sports resume in certain limited capacities in certain areas. There are certain restrictions. There are certain things going. So if that happens, if it's approved later on today or tonight, that means two phases of businesses and schools in Illinois will be reopening as a sort. So anyway, if you want more details on the high school sports angle of it, we've got Fox 2's. Actually, I'd like to see if any of you have any comments on what's happening in the Metro East. Feel free to comment. As we mentioned, Region 4 moves into Phase 4, which is in Illinois. So comment if you will. In the meantime, here's an update on the high school situation from the Illinois High School Association. Take it away, Jeff Bernthal.
They are hoping the restrictions will be lifted tomorrow, but for now, today, they were just practicing drills. The basketball team was here at the high school, and they are hoping and planning to play this weekend. This letter sent to Illinois Governor J.B. Pritzker is signed by superintendents from the Southwestern Conference calling for current sports restrictions to be lifted.
Our student athletes are struggling from a social aspect to an academic aspect, to a normal aspect of competition. They're hurting.
The superintendent's request to play includes a plan for no spectators, health screenings, COVID testing, no locker rooms, and more time between games.
Let us play.
Athletes are frustrated.
It's been rough. It's ruined a lot of opportunities for me my senior year, like college scholarships and just overall just having fun and playing.
A key factor driving restrictions in the Metro East is capacity at intensive care units. Superintendents say that metric fails to take into account how much capacity is available in St. Louis or how many patients come from outside the region. There's also concern about economic disparities.
If my family can afford to play club sports and pay for that, my child can play. Students that can't afford that are either dependent on those clubs providing them resources to pay their fees, or those students are sitting out. So this has become a case of the haves and the have-nots for many athletes around the state of Illinois.
I never thought I'd see anything like this. It's been a season like none other for all of us, and we're just hoping for the best that we can get a chance to play.
Edwardsville's athletic director is hopeful restrictions will be lifted.
Bottom line, kids are going to be able to get back into gyms and get back on fields and do the things they love to do. There'll be some limitations on fans and things like that, but at the end of the day, the kids are going to have an opportunity to play, and that's all we ask for.
Even though the restrictions could be lifted tomorrow, one reason that letter was sent to the governor is the superintendents say if that the COVID numbers go back up, they worry that these games could be put back on hold. Reporting live from Collinsville, Jeff Bernthal.